The idea of trying to intimidate your opponent by means of propaganda and psychological warfare are often regarded as an invention of the modern battlefield. Yet evidence has been found that suggests that these practices have existed since the earliest days of man.
If you wanted somebody not to bother you in your cave, you would leave a club out there that you know the person approaching your cave couldn't pick up. He would then assume, my God, if the person living there can pick that up, I don't want to know. Alexander the Great used to do exactly the same thing. He had sets of armour made up that would fit Goliath. Huge men, and he would leave them. When he'd withdraw his troops, he'd leave some of these items laying around so that when the locals came back, they would look at this armour and think, goodness me, I don't want to meet these people in daylight, let alone on a dark night. The Assyrians, rude messages on rocks. The Assyrians were great slingers. They've been found with messages carved on rocks, you know, sort of get well soon or a present from so-and-so. You know, it was all there. It's not modern warfare. Nothing is new. It's all been done before.
Throughout history, there have been weapons which have been said to have special, even supernatural powers. These legendary weapons have cast fear into the hearts of enemies and awe into those of their own troops. An infamous terror weapon was later developed that took its cue from catapults, but instead of bolts, it shot fire itself. This was the notorious Greek fire. So secret was this weapon that today its exact dimensions are unknown. What is known is that it spread fear and foreboding amongst the troops that faced it. It spewed out liquid fire in the form of a burning combination of naphtha, nitre and sulfur. Naphtha is a naturally occurring substance, somewhat like crude petroleum, and as such it makes Greek fire a forerunner of modern napalm. The Hellfire concoction was shot out of a tube that's been described as being like a giant syringe. Any flammable thing amongst the enemy was its target. Ships, siege engines, and troops. Its evil reputation spread far and wide, and the mystery of its internal workings survives to this day. The collapse of the Roman Empire in the 5th century AD led to a poorly chronicled period across Europe known as the Dark Ages. In Britain, a legendary leader emerged to fill the power vacuum. His name was King Arthur. Perhaps the fact that little is known about him has led to the growth of myths and stories about his life and times. His success as a military leader has been put down to his ownership of the Sword of Light, Excalibur. This sword, which confirmed his succession, was, according to tradition, smelted in the other world. The story might owe something to the fact that the Celts thought of lightning as a flashing sword. It might also have some connection with the sword of the Irish deity, Nuada. It was said that his sword, once unsheathed, was irresistible and that none could escape it.
The other thing that was a form of psychological warfare was if you thought your army that you were opposing had magical powers, mystic powers, had some edge over yours that they never had. This is where mystic weapons would come into the warfare. We have things like Excalibur, this mystical sword that could chop through anything it had ever seen before it. A mystical sword that would chop through your sword, your armour. So what's the point of opposing somebody like that? All it needs to be is a good quality sword, made of good quality steel, pattern welded, whatever. You are a poor conscript, you've been given a bog iron blade, and you are expected to meet this. Yes, it would slice straight through your terrible armour, that was the cheapest possible. It would slice through your cheap sword. Yes, you would decide to run as opposed to face something like this. Then the legend starts.
Long ago, before the birth of civilization, warfare had a strongly ceremonial aspect. The building of the first city-states brought the first true armies into the world. The story of the first armies of the world is one of the utmost endeavor, courage, ingenuity, and skill. It's also one of cruelty and strife. It could be said that our concept of total war is a legacy inherited from the world's ancient civilizations.